My name is Clémence and today I'm gonna tell you about 50 designer brands and my top one fragrance from them. Egoist, number 5, because a few drops on number 5 and I go to bed.
So I say Chanel number 5.
So it's in my bag. Manifesto Elixir, so sexy. La nuit de l'homme, eau de toilette, soothing, relaxing, very charming. For women, eau demoiselle, for men. Trésor, classique, can't go wrong, the rest I'm not sure. For men, that's just only one, Hypnose. It's really good though. Ouch. Olympia, God, can we go? The scent, warm, easy to wear. La nuit, for women, nice, not offensive. Le mal, of course, clubbing, 90s. For women, I guess classic. Chalimar, 1925, one of the first oriental fragrance, love it. And for men, I can't live without my vetiver. Fresh cologne, casual chic. Durham Intense, can I add Eau Sauvage? Parfum. Ah, that's cheating, okay. For women, Miss Dior, but original. Of course, the poudré, very sensual, classy, projecting, beautiful. And Bleu Noir, underrated. Little Gem, Père d'Hermès, and Kelly Kalesh, power couple. It's a royal couple. I know only one, Girls Can Do Anything. That's a beautiful vanilla bomb. I got a lot of compliments with that. A Profumo, easy date night scent. A Luna, because it's very cute and the most addictive. I really want to say only The Brave, but that's the perfume I gifted to my ex-boyfriend. Let's say Bad. A Flower Bomb and Spice Bomb, iconic couple. Pure Avan and Alien for women. Oh, Alien. Little thought for Mr. Mugler that passed away last week. Took inspiration from him today. Eau de Parfum, classique. One of the cutest flower scents ever. The One, Eau de Parfum, for women, I don't know. Parfum d'été. Nothing is like that anymore. The classic. It does smell a bit like a nail polish remover at the start, but I love that. And for men, Man, because the advertising was with the guy from Game of Thrones. Pour homme, Beau de Jour, one of the most beautiful fougères with that beautiful lavender. A Black Orchid for women, full of character, a little bit gothic, I love it. Yomo. Fresh and gourmand at the same time. Explorer. Compliment getter. Eau masculin. What a beautiful gem. Praline note. And a little bit of anise. Pour homme. For women, bloom. Without enthusiasm. Booster. Alpha male fragrance. If you want something long lasting, there you go. L'envol. Honeyed underrated gem and baiser volé, the most classiest flowery scent. Lily and green notes. The One, revolutionary first unisex fragrance in Sephora. Odyssey, relaxing zen type of fragrance. Giorgio, who remember that? 1881, classic. Dylan Blue, teenage vibe. Pour un homme de 40. Power couple, l'homme, la femme, intense. For the women, teaches you how to be sexy at the office. Avant-garde, sadly discontinued. And arpège, ultimate classic, number 5 line. Repetto, Editi, super easy, fruity, flower, cute. London, for men and women, you can't go wrong. Maybe with the masculine one, that smells a bit like Christmas, but the ladies. Eden, all my childhood. Midnight in Paris, the most beautiful amber, and the packaging is to die for. A Jaipur, homme and femme, like a classic vibe with a pinch of exotism. Dracar noir, what else? Polo, the green one. Décadence, how cute is that little handbag? Very, very sexy. I like it. Man intense, 100%, long lasting, powerful. Thé blanc for women? The classic. Gold couture. Apparently, you get older men with this caramel fragrance, so. Voilà. Hein. Cavalli classic. Sunny, sultry, strong pink pepper. I'm loving it. That's my favorite from 50 Designers. If you want more of this kind of video, let me know. You can subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to do that. That takes you 10 seconds of your life. It's free and it makes me happy. Oh yeah, and don't be offended. Like if you're like, Clemens, you forgot this one. I had to choose one. It's hard. Anyway, have a lovely afternoon. Bye-bye.